Hi friends, do you want to dual boot your Windows 10 PC with the Linux Mint? So in that condition, you first require the ISO image of Linux Mint, okay, that you can easily download from the site linuxmint.com. Okay, you have to go for the linuxmint.com and you have to go for the download section. In download section, you have to go for the Linux Mint. Okay, if you goes down, so you have the option, you know, to download which version that you want to download. It's available in the 32-bit or 64-bit, so you have to download. And after that, you need, if you want to use the USB, means with you want to make that bootable image with the USB, so you have to go for the Rufus tool. Rufus is the one of the best tool that you use for creating bootable USB. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to go down and you need to download the software, and after installation this wizard will become. Okay, in this wizard, this one is your, you have to be insert your USB or flash drive here. Okay, and it will be select that one, and minimum 4 GB is required. And after that you have to be just provide your image path from this. You have to click on this icon and you have to be provide the image path that you downloaded from the linuxmint.com, and after that you have to click on start to make that one bootable. Okay, and if you want to use the DVD, so must be go for the image burner. You have to go for the fileipo.com and you have to search for image burner and you have to be download this one, and with this one you can easily make your DVD as a bootable. Okay, and after, and also you needed minimum 10 GB space in your hard drive that you want to boot, and it must be free space. Okay, now let's start. And if you go for my PC, actually as you seen here in my PC, I have 30 GB of space, that's in my C drive. Okay, and I don't have miss other drive, that is showing it's a E drive, it's not functional. And after that you have to go for the start menu, and then after you have to select the option disk management, because we want to make our space available. So what you have to do, you have to just shrink this volume. Just right click on your drive that you, and then after you have to select the option sync volume, because you want to extend your volume, that if you don't have, if you have blank space that you can use. Okay, so minimum 10 GB is required, so I'm going to assign 15 GB for this job. And after that you have to click on the shrink. Okay, and it's a depend up to your configuration. So it, as you seen here, now it's a unallocated space is showing. So after that I have to go for this new simple volume, and you have to be click on next, and you have to again click on next and leave as it is, and then after again next, and now same option you need to format, and then click on the finish. Okay, so it will make your drive available, that's that we required for the installation of our Linux Mint operating system. It will take little bit time, nothing to worry about it. Okay, as you seen here, now your drive is ready, and this error is coming because I have problem in my OneDrive, so it will not comes to you, nothing to worry about it. Okay, as you seen here, my drive is now ready for this installation. So what you have to do, if you go for this drive option, okay, as you seen here, now I have one free space, one available free drive that I can use. Okay, and you need to be use for this install, for this demonstration I want to go for the DVD drive that I already make the bootable. So I need to be just boot boot from this Linux Mint operating system. Okay, as you seen here, now it's a coming to me. Okay, as you seen here, now my PC is booting. So what you have to do, you have to one icon install Linux Mint, you have to go for on your desktop, you have one option to just you have to just click on the install Linux Mint. Okay, this icon you have to be click on install Linux Mint. Okay, now you have to choose your language, whatever language that you want to use. Okay, as you seen here, we have the enough space, 10 GB and plug-in charger, and it's also connected to the internet. Okay, now you have to choose the option something else. because you want to use, you don't want to erase your drive, you just want to dual boot. Okay, so you have to just select the option something else here, and then after you have to click on the continue. Okay, now you have to do the partition. You have to be careful about here. Actually, as you seen here, we have the three partition. Okay, one is for Windows recovery, and now you have to in the third partition that you make for the your Linux mint. So actually, time being, I just want to select 12 GB for my main partition, and 3 GB I will left for my swap partition. Okay, here you have to be select the option your extension 4 for general file system. Okay, as you see, now you have to define your mount point as a root. Okay, if you have enough space, that you can also define for your home directory, but here I'm just defining for my root drive. Okay, and then after you have to click on the okay, and then after you have to be click on the okay. So this partition will be going to be formatted in the extension 4. You have to just click on the continue here. Just click on the continue. So this will be formatted in the your extension 4 means extension 4 5 format, and 3 GB space you have the for swap partition, that you again you have to define. As you seen here, now it's your drive is going to be formatted in the extension 4 file format, and now you have approx 3 GB data free space that you need for the swap partition. Double click on it. Okay, now you have to be choose this option, you know, use as a you have to select the option swap swap area. You just need swap area, and then after you have to be click on the okay to just make this one a space as a swap area. Click on okay. Okay, so now you have the two means in your PC. Now you have the, as you seen here, two is for, one is for system reserve, that is NTFS, and one is for your Windows operating system, that is also NTFS. Now third one is extension 4, and fourth one is your swap partition. So now you have to click on the install now option to install this one. Click on the continue because you want to write the changes. Okay, so now it will be take time, it will start the installation of your, now you have to choose your location where you are. Currently I'm in Dubai, so I have to choose my location Dubai, and then after you have to choose your keyboard layout, then after click on next, and now you have to enter your information, your user ID and password. And if you want to encrypt your home directory, select encrypt my home folder option. Okay, now it will be just next net finish, you have to do nothing. Okay, and it will take little bit time that is required upon your PC configuration. Okay, so you have to just wait and watch, you have to do nothing here. As you seen here, it's an automatic installing. It's just try to fetch all the files, and then after it will be download from your internet and your DVD drive. Okay, and when it's completed, so after that you are able to dual boot. Okay, so now click on the restart now, and then after it will be boot in the your grub boot letter will be comes, and now you have option to choose your Windows partition, Windows operating system, and also Linux Mint. Okay, same as it is showing. So hope you like my videos, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.